Let's go, boy.
What is up, everybody? Welcome back to The Calling. Nah, I'm just kidding. But what's up, everybody? Welcome back to the Buffalo Bob channel. And today we're going to be going over my fishing tackle. I'm going to be just showing you what tackle I have, maybe hooks, baits, whatever, just so you guys can see what I'll be throwing on this channel in the future. So let's get right into it. Hope you guys enjoy, like, subscribe, all that good shit. Let's go, baby. First we're going to get into is the worms. Worms. So, got Yum blue and black worm, Mondo worms, Lunker logs, purple and black, more blue worms mixed with some shit in there. Got the power baits, got power baits in there. X zone drop, you can tell that they're empty because I caught quite a few bass on them. I do recommend they're more of a drop shot rig, but they're still worms. More Lunker logs. These are probably some of my favorite, again, mixed in there, but the Zoom Red Shad. Of course, there's some little Spider-Man worms, I like to call them, by culprit, not really calling Spider-Man worms. More cheap Zoom worms. That clearance section be going hard. Again, more Zoom worms, just longer in the green. Good old cheap Lucky Strike. Some more Zoom. Or Yum, those are Yum, my bad. Some little like big bites. I don't know, I got that in a mystery tackle box. Got some Z-Man, little finesse TRD. Got craws in here, not supposed to be in here, so take that out. Got some more Senkos from Big Bites. Walmart's Ozark Trail. Stinker stick. Just the little Senkos. Haven't tried them out yet. I saw on a YouTube video, so picked them up. Want to try them. Haven't got to yet. Waste of money. More Lucky Strikes. A Yum value pack of the red watermelon flake Yums. More Zoom worms. Some older maroon hardtail worms. Some more Zoom worms that are like a lavender color, kind of cool, so I pick those up. More Z-Mans, and some stuff I found in the yard sale, the pink tail, that bitches is going hard. And this is just a quick little overview of my worm box. And there's a couple more worms I forgot about that I just found in my backpack from this weekend. So, got some more power bait, little drop shot worms, some Gary's, some of these little, I don't know, Ollie specials. These little worms I got from a mystery tackle box. These are my favorite worms. They were my favorite, and they probably still are. It's a little Yum mini dinger, I think they're called. Yum dingers, but they're like the mini size, a little cut a little bit, so they're not so big. A lot of small ponds around my area have smaller bass, so it's kind of hard for them to eat that bigger worm. It's a little mini dinger, and that like greenish blue kind of rainbow flake, they seem to like it quite a bit. Some Creme lures, you know, Walmart specials. A mixture of old Strike Kings, you can see there's different colors in there. These are the culprit worms that I was talking about earlier. I like to call them Spider-Man 4th of July specials, whatever. They're blue and red, but I like to call them Spider-Man worms because I'm weird. I got these, just more Senkos and some Purple Haze power bait. Now, they're not named Purple Haze. I'm just a weirdo, and that's what I like to call them. But just some purple and blue flake worms. Nothing special. Purple Haze, baby. So that is all my worms, though. Now we are going to move into the craws. Craws, baby. So, my crawfish. If you're not a Googan Baits fan, might want to skip this part. I don't know why, but I like the Kraken Craws a lot, and you're going to see that. So let's start it off and get it right out the way. First up, we got the Watermelon Kraken Craw. This is probably my favorite one. My favorite colorway, whatever, flavor, whatever the fuck you guys want to call it. The Googan Baits Watermelon Kraken Craw. Red Flake is my favorite. Here's some more. They're used. Okay, yep, ripped up. Okay, then we got the Alabama Craw. Got that. You can see I do use a lot of these, so that's why a lot of them are missing, because I actually catch fish on them and like them. It's got the Rattling Chunk, little green pumpkin. They're real dark, but I don't know if you guys can hear that. There's beads in them, which it makes it kind of special. Then we got some Blue Babies. Got some smaller ones. Little bluish tint to it. I don't know if you can see that there. Greenish blue tint to it. So that's pretty cool. Moving on. We got the Okeechobee Craw. Okeechobee Craw. Got that blue and black flake to it. But again, I don't know if you can hear that, but it's got the rattle in it. So that's pretty cool. More just red flake. Watermelon. Here we got the White Craws. I haven't got a chance to use these yet. I'd like to wait for springtime for, you know, on beds, but you know, I have used one actually right here, but it's just a nice trailer. But you also can Texas rig it, whatever you want to do, and hopefully it gets bites. And then we got some just more black and blue flake Kraken Craws. Last but not least, for the Googan Baits, we have the Natural color. Now the Natural, you see the one missing out of this pack. Cool little backstory. I was at work, we got rained off middle through the day. I work construction, so it started raining about 1 o'clock. I went through this rainstorm, drove to a lake near me, Atisco Lake, if anybody knows where that is. Drove down there, threw this baby on there on a Texas rig, and away to Texas rig, and I got this guy right there. It was a pretty fun catch, pretty cool, but that was off the Natural one. And yeah, all right, I'm running out of space under my light here. You guys can see all the Googan bait packs. Those are my favorite craw, and it might just be my favorite lure really at all is the Googan Bait Kraken Craw. But let's get into more craws here. We got the 10,000 Fish Craw, blue and black. Got some blue and black little craws there from Big Bite Baits. Got Candy Red Flake craws, some Candy Red craws from Zoom. They're pretty cool. I got a value pack of black yums I had to put in a bag because the little Ziploc part broke, but there's black and blue little craws from Yum. Got some more Yum value pack, you know, that clearance going hard. Got some Ned baits, some little Ned rig baits, just red and white. Little craws here from Big Bite Baits. Got some cheap little, more realistic looking color. I mean, obviously not the colors like the brown and orange, but they look more realistic than these other ones, but I don't know. They're my favorite trailers to use. They are the Bruiser Baits Crazy Craw, the blue and black. I like to throw this on a nice jig head and use it as a trailer, and does me pretty well. So that is it for my craws. Once again, just a quick little look at the craws. Got a whole mixture in there. Keep the micro. But got a whole little mixture in there, mainly all Googans though. But that is the craws. Now we're gonna move to the creature baits. Some tubes. I don't know if you'd consider tubes as a creature bait, but I know what else to consider them, so fuck off. Step off!
Time for you to step off!
These creature baits are not made by Big Bites. These I made myself, but I didn't know what other bag to put them in. So, I'll put them in here. These are just Googan Bait Mandito Bugs, but as I said in my previous video, but yeah, this is a bait I made myself, poured it. It's supposed to be like a little, I don't know, like a little creature bait. I don't fucking know. Some kind of imitation of something, but I'm just a YouTuber, you know what I mean? Some Zoom Lizards. Just some, you know, natural green pumpkin looking stuff. Got some black tubes. It's really hard to see, but it's really messy, and I'm not trying to get my hands all dirty right now. We got some red flake Mandito bugs. As you can see, as I just showed you, this is Googan Baits. These are mine. Mandito bugs, theirs is a little bit darker, their flakes are a little bit better. And this is mine, a little bit of a lighter green, but still got the flakes in there. I didn't make it with the same flakes, and like I didn't melt down a bunch of Guggen Bandito bugs and then made this one. I actually just took extra little leftover, whatever, old Sankos, just burnt down stuff. But that's what you can see in this one. It's got like a greenish blue flakes, and this is just straight red and green and whatnot, no blue at all. But little comparison, mine, Guggen baits. But back to the video. Anyway, as I was saying, man, yeah, I got these Guggen baits, red flake, these little lizards. I think this was Savage Gear, but I took out the whole thing because I wanted to cut you a couple. It was just making a mess. But got these cool little lizards. I haven't used much, just one or two, and haven't caught a bass on it yet. So I don't know if it's great. Looks good in the water, though. More Bandito bugs. These ones are just green, I believe. Summer craw. They're nuggets. Some green pumpkin trench hogs. These are the black and blue trench hogs. They're like some old rattlesnakes. They're not a creature bait at all. Just like a little minnow, but they're in the box, so I guess I'll just show you. More Bandito bugs from Guggen Bait, black and blue. This is the 10,000 fish Sakoshi bug. Now, I haven't tried to, got a chance to use these yet. Creme lures, little lizard wannabe brush hog thing from Zoom. But they are a little imitation of a brush hog. I got the real brush hogs from Zoom. This is my cousin's favorite brand, favorite bait, brush hog. This is really all he uses. You go through his tackle boxes, all you'll really find this and maybe some Rapalas. But Zoom brush hog, it's pretty good. Watch to catch a lot of fish, highly suggest. This is some more Zoom lizards. They are like a gold flake. Thought they were pretty cool, picked them up. Again, haven't got to use them. Some more baby brush hogs, more baby brush hogs, some big bites lizards, and more creme green pumpkin brush hogs. So that is gonna do it for all my creature baits. Sorry, boys and girls, I had to take a quick little dinner break, but this seems like a good time to give some shout outs. So shout out Killicam 28. Right there, that is my little brother's channel. Go check it out. I highly advise it. It's a good channel, good videos, a mixture of stuff, some gaming, some reviews, some rating videos. I don't know, man. Just go check it out. It's a pretty good channel. Go check out my boy, Almighty Eric. I'll put it right here. Go check his channel out, man. His last YouTube short is doing pretty well. I'm very happy for him. He's getting some views, getting respect he finally deserves. Puts in a lot of time, a lot of hard work, and the editing and whatnot. He's the best editor I know. Go check him out, man. He's pretty good. Next one is going to be Miklos Man channel right here. This is my uncle's channel. He's trying hard. YouTube keeps screwing him over, but, you know, happens to the best of us. Shout out Logan's Goated. Put that right here. Logan's Goat is my little brother. He does, I don't really know what he does, but go check him out and let me know if you like it. And last but not least, somebody I forgot in all my previous videos. Zach, I'm dearly sorry. Go check out Tapeworm, man. I'll leave him right here for about 30 seconds. Maybe 10, not sure. Go check out Tapeworm, man. Last but not least, Tapeworm. Tapeworm, I am sorry. Go check out his channel right here. He does a lot of podcast stuff about anime, about certain little series that he likes. He does podcasts. I think he's gonna start doing gaming, but I would go check it out. It is my little brother. I'm sorry, Zach, I haven't shot you on the extra videos. I'll leave your channel up for more. Everybody, back to the video. Now we're gonna go into my jigs. This is my jig box. So I'm not a huge jig guy. I have caught fish off jigs, just not much. I'd like to get into it more, but like I said in previous videos before, my job, I don't get to fish as much as I would like to. So I like to go with Texas rig and some top water, stuff I know that's gonna catch. And jigs is just not that. So this one, I got a little crack and craw on there. Blue and black flake, nothing too special, nothing too crazy. This little jig tube thing, but I don't have a jig on it right now. Some more trailers. Got this nice little white jig with the white crack and craw. I can tell it's a little sun faded, it's not as white anymore. This isn't really a jig, but you jig it, and I just kind of threw it in my jig box. Shout out Blakey for that one, by the way. Got this nice little jig right here, green and orange and white, little jig head. Another green jig, another little trailer, tube jig, more trailers. This is probably my favorite jig. Not that I've caught a fish with it, but it just looks cool. It was just the perfect match made in heaven, it seemed. I found this like little jig trailer. Well, I don't even know if that's what it's made for, but I just got it off this like cheap little website. Just came with something, and I'm like, what the fuck would I ever use that with? It was perfect for a jig trailer, and like the flakes and everything matched right up. So that was great. I thought that was pretty cool. Little shrimp jig trailer. I don't know. I just threw it in my jig box. I didn't really know what to do with it. Again, back to my Bruiser Baits Craws. I put this as my favorite trailer to use. I've caught a bass with this. Not a couple of bass with it, actually, but this is probably one of my favorite jigs and my trailers. I got this little hair jig with a trailer on it. Nothing crazy. Got some seaweed in it. But that is it for my jigs. Now we're going to get into my box that I keep my spinner baits, buzz baits, and my chatter baits. That would be this Mitchell Tackle Box. I don't like to throw away the boxes. Might as well make a use of it. Free tackle box, right? I got an unwrapped Booyah little mini spinner here. I just bought today at Walmart. We're going to start out with a cheap little Walmart special. Little red spinner bait here. Little trailer. Not too crazy. And we got this buzz bait here. A little white buzz bait. No trailer on it. I haven't really used it yet. Got this white spinner bait here. Again, nothing crazy. No trailers on it. We got this spinner bait. First chatter bait I got here. The Z-Man chatter baits. Ow, fuck, burnt, oh, god damn it, shit, poked shit on myself. Got a little spinner here, got this crazy little purple pumpkin fucking spinner looking thing. Okay, little highlighter, little spinner, nothing crazy. This, I think I got out of Mr. Tackle Box, little spinner. I think they're Sam's Baits, I want to say it's called. Again, another little chatter bait. Haven't got to get out used too much, but got that little Rage Tail, Rage Swimmer trailer on it. Looks prime. Haven't used it yet. So, that is my spinner baits, my buzz baits, and my chatter baits. On to the next. Next, I don't know. Might be my favorite box, man. This is a love-hate relationship, but it's going to be my top water box. For the writing on it, it is something my girlfriend put on there for one of my anniversaries. So, it was a love box. A love box, I guess you can call it, means a little bit more to me. So, why not put my favorite kind of fishing in there? Top water. First off, we're going to start here. Got the Guggen Revolver Popper. Probably one of my favorite baits ever. Very simple, very old school and classic. But this one is a Booyah Popper. Got it in Mystery Tackle Box. But the Popper is probably one of my favorite. Hula Popper is probably one of my favorite lures ever. Caught a lot of my biggest fish on it, a lot of pike on it. Honestly, any pike I've really caught was off of hula poppers and a lot of big bass. I'll show you a picture of one of my pike I caught right here off a hula popper. And yeah, they're tangled together. So yeah, here would be another little red and silver one. Just some top waters, but they haven't got rigged up yet. Oh, more hula poppers. Got the Booyah Pad Crasher. This is probably my favorite frog. It's just very detailed, looks good. I do like to trim the legs a little bit. I think they're a little long, a little bit of a smaller profile, but it does catch me the most bass. I'll put you a picture here. Have missed a few blow-ups, but I think it was my own mistake, not the hooks. Very soft body. I highly recommend. Stars out of 5. I do like the Pad Crasher. Now, this is just another Pad Crasher. I buy multiples because I like them. This is a Popping Frog by Lunker Hunt, I believe. These are just good old Walmart specials, about a dollar and some change. And I haven't caught fish off them, but I definitely advise the Booyah over it. Again, just a nice little black Popping Frog. Again, I bought the Antiques. These old sons of bitches at Walmart are like 80 cents, but I heard like back in the day, that's all they had for topwater frogs. Dear God, bless you people back then. These frogs suck, all right? I'd never use these. Had one blow up, missed it. Terrible. Sometimes they don't even float the way they're supposed to. There's a reason why they're 80 cents. Don't go cheap. Go the extra couple bucks and get yourself even the cheap Walmart frogs, but popping frog, walking frog, whatever. Just don't buy these. These things suck. And yeah, that is about it for my topwater lures. Now, boys and girls, we're going to go into my swim baits. Off kicker off with some cheap stuff here. We go to, I think I saw these at Dick's Sporting Goods, right? Go up there, you got them in like the little $2 or $3 bin or whatever. First off, we got this little guy right here. Got them on an Amazon package. I have used them. Got to swim a little slower. You can't really troll that well with them because then they kind of skip on top of the water. They were kind of cheap, but they do work, does swim, and I did catch a pickerel off of this one, but this little perch colored guy and this little shad colored guy. Nice little swim baits. All together, all four of these were like, I don't know, 15 bucks or something. It was worth the money, I'd say. Next one, we got this very cool, detailed looking bluegill sunfish, some kind of sunfish. It's very cool, nice action to it. I haven't got a chance to throw this one yet, a little bit bigger, but it is nice and wasn't too expensive. I think it was only like 13 bucks. This one is going to be my most expensive I bought. I have gotten a bass and a pickerel on this, and honestly, I'm very cheap. I don't like to throw things that cost a lot of money because I'm scared of losing it, but I did throw it at one of the ponds I went to and caught a couple fish in a couple minutes. Nice little sunfish, beautiful action on it. This little guy was about 25 bucks by itself. A little overpriced in my fucking opinion, but I'm a cheap bastard, so what can you say? Swims well. Great pickup, though. All right, now we're going to go on to the Mondo Mama here. I know a lot of bass fishermen, they use big swim baits. I don't have a lot of luck in it, and when I throw them, kind of breaks my pole, but this big guy, right? Doesn't look that big, but to me, it's pretty damn big. Now, I have got a lot of big bass to follow this, just no hits yet. I did throw this at Yeaman Park, if you know where that is. It's a shitty fishing hole, but there is some decent-sized bass in there. It's a pretty big pike. I did throw this guy around a little bit. I'd like to take him to some bigger lakes, but just for an idea for size, this one is like a decent-sized lure that I typically would use. Yeah, okay, this is like the great-grandfather, okay? This is pretty big. This is like a normal size, you know what I mean? It's pretty big, bro. This thing's like a pound and a half. It's pretty, shit, pretty heavy. I don't really know what to call these, but these are more of like crappy lures and pan fishing lures. I don't know if I'm taking them out because this video is already way too long. But just little mini guys, and I've caught a lot of rock bass off them and pickerel. So it's just them. They're pretty good. Today I have picked up these little mini micro little guys, if you can see those. Picked those up today to get some panfish. And yeah, that's about it for that. So little mini lures, I guess you can call those. And that is that. Now I'm going to go into my pike box. I just kind of named this my pike box because this is mainly all the big ass lures I don't know what else to do with. So kind of just threw it in there at the pike section. For example, got this guy here, pretty big. I had a pike chase it, but hadn't hit it. So we got that. Got this big guy I found a yard sale, huge old blue fox, pretty big. One of these big old power spin things here. Okay. This huge plastic swim bait on here. Jig head, it's pretty heavy. Gotta swim that pretty slow. Tube jig, don't know why that's in there. Okay. One of my little jointed big jerk baits. This whole mess here. Got big spoons, you know, for pike. I guess I could use this for tiger muskie too if I go into ponds or lakes, not ponds, lakes with tiger muskie. But, you know, just huge spoons and whatnot. More of a spoon like this I caught my first northern pike on when I was a kid. If I can find the picture, I'll put it in here. If I can't, well, then I guess you won't see it. But big jerk baits, okay? That's what I got, just huge jerk baits. This jerk bait, the exact same one, but it's just green. I don't have any more because it's broke. Most recent northern pike I caught on with this. This is probably my favorite pike lure. Now, not that I've reeled a pike in with this, but I've gotten many and many a bites. I don't know if the hooks are great. I don't know if you can tell right there that hook's kind of bent from a pike on this back hook right here, the back treble. But this is probably my favorite. It's got that highlighter top, red, nice silver bottom. Swim action's great. I've gotten a lot of hits. A lot of these I haven't got to use. This is actually a a lake trout lure, but I'm sure it'll work. That is my pike stuff. Now we're gonna go into my crankbaits. This is my crankbaits. Crankbait box, a little double-sided, got in a yard sale. We're gonna go into it. Got this cool little crankbait, got it the other day at a yard sale. Garage sale, yard sale, whatever you wanna call it. Same place I got this cool little bait caster. And I caught my first fish on the other day. That was pretty cool. First bass off of a bait caster, first fish at all. It's a little like lipless crank. Pretty cool. A bigger size lipless crank from Live Target, I believe it is. Haven't really done that yet. Get caught in a lot of weeds. It's very heavy. Again, yard sale. Got this big guy. I'm going to take this to the lake. See what she can do. Again, just some bigger crankbaits. I'd like to take to the lake some bigger crankbaits. A lot of them are hooked up here, but nice big size to them. Should dive fairly deep here. Pretty excited to use those. I'm sweating, sorry. Those crankbaits. Got that beautiful red crawfish color in there. That was pretty cool pick up. Got this little mud brown one here. Facebook Marketplace specials, some Walmart specials. Got all sorts of crankbaits here, man. I never really had much faith in crankbaits because, like I said, I pond hop a lot, so I don't get to use them a lot because I get caught in weeds. Weeds, rocks, all sorts of stuff. But once I started doing a little bit more of lake fishing, I started to fall in love because that is all I find myself really using is these guys. So I started getting more into it, and I still don't have enough. Enough is never really enough. So you guys might see this and be like, wow, this is a lot, you know. Shit, what'd I do? Oh, my PS4 turned off. That's tragic. Sorry, my light went out. But like I said, a lot of people, you know, I'm sure a lot of people have more than me. Some might not have as much as me, might have less. You know, I'm not trying to make it a competition. I just showing you what I have, what I use. They are a tangled mess, but yeah, I have a decent amount of crankbaits, decent amount of tackle in general, and I'm very appreciative of everything I have. And yeah, man, so that's gonna be just about everything I do believe for my tackle. Of course, I have terminal tackle, you know, I got hooks, I got bullet weights, all that kind of stuff, but I don't want to make this video too long. It's already too long. But if you made it this far in the video, man, I appreciate the hell out of you. Like, subscribe, all that good jazz. And thank you very much for everything and all the views and the love and support. Thank you for watching Buffalo Bob. I'm out.